بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أنا الطالب هشام زهر وأعضاء الجروب مهتز كامل لبنى حسين ليما سمارة وحلل حلمان. اخترنا موضوع النيوكلير ميديسن وبالأخص رح نتحدث عن البت، وكل شخص من أعضاء الجروب رح يحكي عن موضوع بتعلق في تطورات صارت على البت. ورح بلش أنا في الحديث عن الأدفانسز في البت دياغنوستكس تو فور جايدينج تارجتد كانسر ثيرابي اند ستاديينج ان فيفو كانسر بيولوجي. نعطي شورت انترودكشن عن الموضوع، انه البيت ايميجينج بتسمح لنا انه احنا نحدد الكانسر، والبيت ايميجينج كمان كان كوانتيفاي اوريجينال كانسر موليكولار تو جايد التارجتد كانسر تريتمنت. وبالنسبه للهدف من هذا من هاي البيبر هي انه احنا نعزز التقدم في مجال البيت كانسر دياجنوستكس، وهذا الشيء تم عن طريق شغلتين. الاولى انه نحسن في البيت انسترومنتيشن، وايضا نحسن في البيت راديو تريسر. بالنسبه للبيت انسترومنتيشن راح نحسن في شغلتين، الاولى في تايم اوف فلايت، وهذا الاشي عن طريق انهم يستخدموا فاستر ديتكتور، وايضا تكون امبروفد الكترونكس. هذا راح يسمح لهم انه يحددوا بشكل دقيق التايم ديفرنس اوف ديتكشن اوف ذا بوزيترون انهيليشن فوتونز. والشغلة الثانية بالبت انسترومنتيشن هي انه استخدام السيليكون فوتو ملتبلايرز، وصح انه مكلف ولكن انه هو كومباكت، وايضا بسمح لهم انه تو لوكالايز التحديد عشان يحددوا الفوتونات على سمول ديتكتور كريستلز. وهذا الاشي احنا نعرف انه راح يزيد عندي الريزوليوشن، او راح يحسن الريزوليوشن ويزيد عندي الاكيوريسي. وبالنسبة للبت راديو تريسرز استخدموا دول تريسر انجكشنز، ومع التجارب وتوضح عندهم انه هذا الاشي زاد عندهم المعلومات عن الريجينال كانسر بيولوجي. وبعد تطبيق هذه الميثودولوجي الريزلت كانت انه حسن تحسين في صار لي تحسين في الكانسر ايميجينج بايو ماركرز، وايضا زاد عندي الفهم الاشخاص عن الهيومن كانسر بيولوجي.
يعطيكم العافية، أنا الطالب ابن حسن. اليوم رح نحكي عن current steps of PET imaging and neuro-oncology. بداية، positron imaging tomography PET is a functional imaging technique that uses radioactive substances known as radiotraces to visualize and measure changes in metabolic processes and in other physiological activities including blood flow, regional chemical composition, and absorption. Now as an introduction, in the recent past, a high number of diagnostic challenges have been addressed using PET techniques, like non-invasive grading in primary brain tumors, prediction of molecular markers, detection of tumor portion with malignant progression, and evaluation of prognosis in newly diagnosed and untreated brain tumors. For neuro-oncologists and medical professionals, these following indications for PET imaging are of particular clinical interest. The first indication, the identification of neoplastic tissue, including the delineation of tumor, extend for the further diagnostic and therapeutic management. Second indication, the differentiation of treatment-related changes from tumor progression and follow-up. The last indication, the assessment of response to a certain anti-cancer therapy, including its predictive effect on the patient's outcome. Now we will talk about PET traces. For cancer diagnosis in general oncology, PET imaging using FDG has evolved over the last decades into the most important clinical PET modality. Increased glucose metabolism indicates by an increased FDG uptake is commonly seen in proliferating tumors due to the increased glucose transporter expression and the enzyme hexokinase converting FDG to phosphorylated product. Now, conclusion. The present literature provides strong evidence that PET can be of a great clinical value for the most important, probably, results and relieved benefit for patients with a brain tumor and justifies a more widespread use of this diagnostic tool. Furthermore, the necessary PET infrastructure is widely available, and the production of radio-labeled amino acids and SSTR ligands is well established with comparable cost to FDG. Moreover, additional cost of this method can be potentially saved by incurred cost of less reliable diagnostic imaging techniques. And thank you.
My name is Lima Samara, and I'm going to be talking about time of flight. But out of every imaging modality we talked about, nuclear medicine, specifically PET, is witnessing a gradual development in terms of image resolution. This is where the time of flight technology comes into place. Not only does it provide a higher image quality, but also more accurate mass and lesion detection. This is very crucial when it comes to certain types of tumors and cancerous cells. البيبر اللي I chose discusses ال development scintillators و as well as ال photo sensors in addition to the associated electronics readout. هلا بالconventional PET احنا كنا نحكي انه ال coincidence annihilation happened along 180 degrees line وكنا نحكي انه كانت تكون ال angle between the two detectors كانت 180 درجة بس ما كنا نحدد بالضبط وين اللوكيشن where the actual annihilation coincidence happened. هلا this is where the time of flight to development comes into place. It is able to detect in distance as well as the attenuation of the photons بالإضافة لل specific location of the coincidence annihilation that happened. هلا as for the scintillators بالنسبة لل time of flight PET, the scintillators had higher stopping power than conventional PET. وحكينا the stopping power is the energy of the photon that the crystal is able to stop. فبالتالي بال time of flight it's able to stop higher energy photons. برضو higher light output. This is related to the efficiency. معناته it has higher efficiency as well as short decay time. هلا as for the photosensors, عندنا high gain, low noise and fast timing. فبالتالي improved عندي this improves the signal to noise ratio. هلا هون عندي a picture that illustrates الفرق بين the time of flight and non time of flight بالإضافة لل CT. هلا بال time of flight بنلاحظ هون في عندي زي mass أو زي lesion مش موجود بال non time of flight. This is regarding the accurate mass detection اللي حكينا عنه. هون برضو بنلاحظ the difference in resolution. بنلاحظ انه with time of flight the picture has higher image quality than without it. Thank you so much for listening.
Research done by the IEEE in 2020 talks about a very important advancement in PET image reconstruction. Deep learning is a specific sub-discipline of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is actually very widely used, and it has so many applications in almost all of the fields. Deep learning usually involves artificial neural network mappings of inputs to outputs, and we'll talk about two direct ways to apply deep learning for PET image reconstruction. The first one is fully connected layers with CNN, using a library to recombine these mappings sequentially, creating a deep network composed of both fully connected and convolutional layers. As you can see, these are the fully connected layers and the convolutional layers. The CNN is used to denoise by seeking to represent the image as a spare collection of features found from the convolutional layers. The second way is convolutional encoder-decoder, which does not actually use any sort of layers. Instead, this approach uses convolutional downsampling to transform progressively from sinogram domain towards a learned latent space representation, which has a very limited spatial sampling, but instead it's extremely rich in features. The latent space representation is then upsampled, this is the upsampling, progressively in the decoder part of the network in order to express the latent space information as the form of PET image, which shows at the end here. Thank you.
I am Matas Melkawi. I will talk about the positron emission tomography in mucosal melanomas of head and neck. Introduction. cause of melanomas is RR disease, arise in the extracutaneous sites from the melanocytes present in mucosal membrane of the respiratory tract and gastrointestinal and urogenital tract in the head and neck. The mucosal melanomas arise from the mucosal line of the nasal cavity, sinus, and the anoral cavity. Apart from mucosal membrane, they can also arise from the melanocytes present in the eye and lip to meninge. The aim of the study to evaluate the accuracy of the fluorodeoxyglucose FDG, PET CT in staging and restaging of patients with MM of the head and neck. Material and method. Method experiment تمت على 19 patient, 12 for staging and 7 for restaging. The patients, some of them with MM of the nasal cavity, paranasal sinus, and oral cavity. All PET CT scans were evaluated for the ability to detect the primary disease, nodal, and other sites of metastasis. خلال experiment, تم حساب sensitivity, specificity, with positive protective value, negative protective value, and also diagnostic accuracy at 95% confidence level. For PET CT image protocol, first, all patients were asked before the study, and blood glucose level were checked. For CT scan, parameter include 140 kilovolt, 110 milliampere, 0.8 scan per rotation, field of view 50 centimeter, and slice thickness 3.75 millimeter. بالنسبة للبت scan, the type of crystal is BGO plus crystal, with dimension 3.8 millimeter, 3.8 millimeter, 3.8 centimeter. As a result, the primary tumor lesion was detected in 18 out of 19 patients, as one patient referred for restaging had only metastatic disease. Nodal metastatic were detected in 11 out of 19 patients and was false negative in one patient. A metastatic brain lesion in the front lobe was not detected using ELBIT image, which was detected by magnetic resonance image and confirmed by histopathological in the following table in the next slide. A distant metastatic lesion were detected in the 6 patient of whose 5 patient had metastatic metallurgical activity disease, and in 1 patient non-FDG avoid lung nodules were detected. As we see in this table, بعرض لي sensitivity و specificity و other parameter. لما استخدمنا ال FDG PET CT scan to detect the primary tumor, nodal tumor and other metastasis tumor. بنلاحظ انه ال FDG PET CT image for detected the primary tumor بيعطيني 100% for specificity, sensitivity and other parameter. The PET CT demonstrated good overall accuracy in evaluation of patient with MM of the head and neck. Combination of CT and PET is an added advance and make it possible for anatomical localization.